Kailangan lang naman talaga sa actually sa lahat ng sport is disiplina lang talaga.
Okay.
So, sabi nga ni Agata Wong, I remember yung sinabi niya sa press na kailangan mong maging motivation yung disiplina mo. Hindi mo itutuon yung ibang discipline mo, yung motivation mo sa ibang tao or to something else. Mm-hmm. Because if you lack, you lost that motivation, mm-hmm. you're nothing. Okay. So dapat yung disiplina yung magiging key. Mm-hmm. Because if wala nang motivation, the discipline will help you na babangon ka talaga at magti-training. At
kahit na ayaw mo na.
Yeah.
Okay, now, the question, guys, is this. Okay, is this a sport for every Filipino? Or at the moment, puro lang kayo mga may kaya, na mga mahilig manood ng TV, na nag-iilusyon na magiging The Rock?
So I think anyone in the Philippines can try out obstacle course racing if they really want to pursue obstacle course racing. Mm. The only expensive part is the training facilities. So okay. Training there, I think that's what costs more than the rest.
But I disagree with that. Actually, si Kaizen dito sa Maynila, nasanay na sila sa obstacles. Kasi meron talaga silang obstacle training dito. But way back sa Davao City ako eh.
Okay.
So wala kaming mga ganyang facility doon. Mm. And what makes us become elite because we try to figure out how to do the same obstacle without the itself, the obstacle itself. So naghahanap kami ng paraan para maging magawa pa rin namin yung mga obstacle.
In fact, you remind me of this street sport.
Parkour?
I think it started in the States.
Yeah.
Where you run through the city, you jump from, from this building to that pavement.
Yeah, parkour. Free running.
Yes.
Okay. And parang sabi ko, dyan ba nagsimula? Is that where obstacle course racing started? Or was this really pure and simple? You saw it on TV?
I saw it in YouTube.
Okay, YouTube ka. Okay. And in your case, there was already an established course.
Yes, there was.
Okay, now, is there the same camaraderie in OCR that you find, like, let's say, with Gilas Pilipinas?
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, talagang matagal na sila, pamilya na sila. Is there such a thing?
For our team, yes, we're actually more than just a team. We're also a family. Mm. So I like how we all support each other and motivate each other, especially in the Southeast Asian Games. Yeah.
Okay. Dante, you are from Davao. Are you bringing this back to Davao or meron na ba sa Davao na OCR?
sa Davao, actually, nag-establish na rin ako ng event doon last year, the Daya OCR. And then, hopefully next year, marami akong balak na gawin doon with the help of the Federation. And then, I hope na lahat ng tao susupport sa sport na ito.
Okay. Any message for the youth, Kaizen? You will apparently be one of the ambassadors for OCR. Sabi nga ni Dante, wala na siyang future kasi 28 na siya. Well, sa Olympics, lolo na siya. What about you?
So for the young athletes, just continue to train and continue to love what you're doing. So if you continue to love what you're doing, then you're gonna excel in the sport.